Hey, Nader Ahmad, how are
Hello.
you?
Well, hello, CP. How have you been doing? After all these years, we finally meet. This is very good. I get a chance to meet you. How have you been doing?
Thank you. I'm very fine. So, what do you want to say to us? Go ahead.
Yeah, so, we've been having these wonderful debates on the Bible, Quran, and modern science, mostly Quran and modern science,
But
and
what,
I have a few
Quran and
challenges.
science? Quran and science?
Absolutely, we've been having these discussions and debates, and I have said Christian has been running away from this debate series because he knows that the Quran is in complete harmony with modern science, and
Okay,
there's clear science.
give us one, give us one, give us one. Let us not waste time, me and you. So for some reason your voice is cutting.
Well,
Give me one,
you need
one
to
miracle.
answer.
Give me one miracle.
Okay, listen, you have to. Why were you running away from me from this debate?
My
People
friend,
said, no, see,
don't
Mr.
make excuses. We are here. Let's see who is running. Give me a miracle. Let us laugh.
Well, here's what I would like to do, Christian Prince. I would like for us to have a public debate on this topic in which.
Abdul, do you want to debate me? You are talking to me right now. Until we have that happen, give me the miracle. Everybody will laugh at you. You are playing like a kid. You call me,
We
you claim, you claim you can debate me. Here we go. We can do it right now. Why next year? Why next century? Do it right now. Otherwise, you are just a kid wasting my time. So I'm listening to you. Please, don't let us speak like adults. Are you going to debate me right now,
Okay,
or you will never do it?
well, first of all, I will, if you want me to give you a scientific miracle right now, I can do that, but I think you should first answer why you are running away from me.
Well, let's see
Answer that
who
to the
is running.
people,
You are
because.
the one who is running. I'm saying to you, let's do it right now. You said no. It's you who's running. Do it. Go ahead.
What I let's do 10 minutes right now, Christian
There's
Prince.
no
I can give
debate.
you, will be
We
one.
talk. It's a crossfire debate. Everybody will hear us. It's a conversation. Go ahead.
Okay, here's the problem. If we don't have set rules with time
My
limits, things
friend,
like that, then we're just going to be
it's a free
insulting
it's
each
a it's a free if it's a free boxing match. Show me. Aren't you the one who speak? You speak, you play karate and you are good in boxing. Do your boxing, free boxing match. Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you, Christian Prince, the
Don't
problem
tell me,
here
my
is what
friend.
I.
Stop making excuses. The rules go for
Oh.
both of us. It's a free. Say whatever you want. Do whatever you want. Go ahead.
But I have a very good excuse. My excuse
No,
from
you
running
have no
from you is
excuse.
this.
You are a coward.
Okay, let me give
You are wasting our time. Are you going to debate me or not?
Okay, what I cannot do, Christian Prince, is
Are
win a
you going
shouting
to
match.
debate me
That's
now or not?
coward on the run. Okay, so we're going to talk about one scientific miracle, and then you're going to agree to debate me later on. Okay, so let's do one science.
I am agreeing to debate you anytime. Here we go. I'm here with you. Go ahead.
CP, we need a format, we need equal time,
At
and we need to
last,
share.
don't call me again. You are just a kid. You don't dare even to talk to me. We need a format. What format? Be a man. You are the one who said you want to debate me. You keep saying I'm running from you. You are just a kid. You are not even equal to my shoe. You don't even know how to say your prophet name correctly. If I call you right now and I ask you to say your prophet name correctly, do you know how to say it? You don't. And you are the one who agree your prophet have sex with the goat. What more I want from you? So either you want to do it now, don't waste my time. I will call you one more time. Either we do debate now. Don't put rules. No rule for you. No rule for me. Speak as much as you want. Get me busted. Go ahead. Let me call you.
That
So,
hurt my feeling.
do you accept or not?
Yes, let's do a debate because I know you'll run away like a coward. So let's just do what
See?
you want. Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Be a man once in your life and talk. Go ahead. Speak as an adult. Go ahead. What do you want to say to us? Go ahead.
Yes, so we're going to do one scientific miracle that
Okay.
proves that the Quran is the truth and you are actually following a demon called Christ. So both the Bible and the Quran actually answers a question on the issue of alcohol. Now, what's very interesting here, there was a study done. I don't have my desktop, which is shared, where I'll show you that study. But in this study, it showed that the Quran actually, Muslim, because of the teachings of the Quran, the Muslim women are 50 times less likely to give a baby, I'm sorry, to give birth to who has fetal alcohol syndrome. The study said you got to go to the Christians because of the influence of the Bible. So the question tonight, which Christian Prince needs to answer here, is, okay, so the book on in the Bible, they gave an answer to this question of alcohol. And when we look at the Quranic answer, it is a far superior answer.
What is the Quran answer? And no, you're not giving me the verse from the Quran, remember. We're talking about
chapter, well, I'm sorry.
Chapter what?
What'd you say?
What chapter?
Chapter 5, verse 9.
What chapter?
Chapter 5, verse 9.
Chapter 5, verse 90. Okay, tell me about it. Go ahead. Now we know what you're talking about. Go ahead.
Okay, and then I'll tell you about it, but I'm following the rule because I know you will not run away from me, and we'll debate on this topic. So that's the agreement here. Okay, so let me go ahead and get the verse in chapter 5, verse 90. Okay. It says, forbidden is alcohol, any kind of intoxicant, gambling.
Okay.
So from the study here, they pointed out that that Muslim women are 50 times less likely to give birth to a fetal alcohol because of the teachings of the Quran. Now, the question is here, which you need to answer, is how is it that the Quran gave a bad response?
Where is speaking about the alcohol is bad? Where it says that?
No, it says, for you, forbidden is any kind of intoxicants.
But where it says it's bad for your health in the verse you quote for me?
That is bad for your health. No, it is completely forbidden for Muslims. This is clear. Okay, and from the study,
I'm asking you a very simple question. You say that this is about health. I'm asking you, why in the verse never say anything about health? It says this is from Shaitan. That's all. Because it's from Shaitan, don't do it, correct?
Yes, this is from Shaitan. And so because as the study concluded, it is the teachings of the Quran, which caused Muslim women to abstain from alcohol. And so the question from again is that how could Allah of the Quran provide a better response than Jesus of the Bible on the question of alcohol? That's a question you need to answer now.
Let's make it clear. I'm just trying to get a full sentence from you. So are you saying the Quran confirmed that alcohol is bad, no matter what?
The Quranic position is that it is forbidden. Yes, no, it's forbidden.
I know it's forbidden. This is not a question. Are you saying that alcohol is bad no matter what? It's bad. It's ugly. Yes or no?
No matter what. But I think these are irrelevant questions you're asking. You're running away from the study.
This is the topic. I want to know if alcohol is bad or it is not bad. Is it bad or not? I mean, what's wrong with you? So you are saying to me, Quran is forbidden alcohol. Okay, forbidden because of what? Because it's good or because it's bad?
Yeah.
What?
You don't understand the question here, so I need you to take some time.
This is my question, not yours. The Quran forbid alcohol. Is it because it is bad or because it's good?
You're saying alcohol is forbidden.
What's wrong with you? Why you are in trouble? Very simple question. How many times I need to repeat? Listen carefully. The Quran forbid alcohol. That's wonderful. Does the Quran forbid the alcohol because it is bad or because it's good?
So the reasons why the Quran forbade, there's actually a reason in the Quran. They said there's some good that outweighs the good.
Why you are making a speech? I mean, the answer is very simple. Allah forbid alcohol because it's bad, or Allah forbid the alcohol because it's good. Which one? Choose one.
I've already given you the answer. I'm going to read it to you, and you got to answer.
I want a clear answer. Is it bad or good? Is alcohol is bad or good?
See, CP, I need you to stop interrupting me. I know you're scared. This is the point you are not able to answer.
Is it bad or good? You are the one who chose the topic. Everybody is my witness, and now you don't dare to answer. What's wrong with you? Okay, Allah forbid alcohol because it's bad or because it's good?
CP, you got to let me, don't interrupt me. We're going to have an intelligent speech.
I mean, the answer is very simple. You call me, you say, according to science, proving that women, they give birth and they have a defect in their birth. That's wonderful. That means alcohol is bad. So why you don't say it's bad? Is it bad or not?
you know, the issue, the Quranic position on alcohol is that there is some good in it.
My friend, is it you who mentioned to me in the beginning saying that science proved that most of women who give a defect birth, the reason for defect birth, and you mentioned the word Christian specifically, that the reason for that, the highest percentage is because of alcohol. So is alcohol is bad or good?
Okay. Your question, if I understand your question, you're saying that overall alcohol a good or bad thing? Is that your question?
I mean, this is even your topic, and you don't even dare to answer. You call me saying that because of drinking alcohol, women give birth to children who have defect in their birth. Okay, that's your claim, and you claim this is from science. That's wonderful. Now, I'm asking you, based on what you told me, is that mean? And based on the Quran forbidding the alcohol, does that mean, according to Allah, alcohol is bad or good?
Oh, I think I understand your question. Your question is, okay, did Allah forbid alcohol for a specific reason of preventing fetal alcohol babies? Is that your question?
No, what's wrong with you? You are in trouble. You are like a cartoon, Mickey Mouse. You're in the corner. You know what to say. I'm asking you, is it bad or good? Very simple. Don't tell me any reason. I want to know, is alcohol, according to the Quran, bad or good?
Bad. Okay, did I answer your question? It's bad. But there's a little bit of good in it.
Finally, you said it is bad. So how come the Quran says it is good? Here we go. This is the chapter 16, verse number 67. You made me lose my voice. Repeating the same question. The Quran says that the alcohol is amazing drink. It's the best. It's a miracle of Allah. Read for me the verses.
Are you finding the verse? I'm sorry, I'm not even looking at your screen. Well, did you want me to respond?
Oh, no, I don't want you to respond. You can call a friend. I mean, what's wrong with you? The Quran says, you said to me, it's bad a second ago. You said to me a second ago, the Quran says that the alcohol is bad. Now the Quran saying that alcohol is a great drink. It's even a miracle from Allah. It is a benefit for mankind. And you can change any translation you want. What translation you want me to put for you on the screen?
Okay. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I'm not even looking at your screen. So let me answer that if I may. Okay, one thing I will require of you, Christian, do not interrupt me in my rebuttal. Because if we're going to have an intelligent debate, we should not be interrupted.
Even a rebuttal, because simply you just said that the alcohol is bad. The Quran is saying the alcohol is amazing. I mean, can you even make a rebuttal?
Yeah. Okay, so let me now respond to you without interruption. Because if you interrupt me, this is an act of cowardice, and this is exactly what I'm saying. He can't handle me in this debate, so he's got to interrupt me. So let me now go ahead and...
We cannot handle you, for sure. You are like a little cat. Answer, how the Quran, the same book, saying alcohol is a sign from Allah, it's a great benefit for mankind, and this is amazing product to use. It's a benefit. You make good deeds from it. You make good money from it. You make good health from it. It is in the top of that. It's a sign from Allah.
Okay, so now you're going to let me speak, or are you going to run away?
I'm waiting for your majesty. Stop complaining about interruption. You can do interrupt me too. We said it's a free form. And your duty here. Supposedly, you are going to show me your knowledge. And your knowledge is a joke. You are just a kid. You choose a topic. Mentioned the topic, and now you do not know what to say because your God said alcohol is amazing. How you answer that?
Okay, I want everybody to understand, when you interrupt somebody, this is an act of cowardice. He's running away because I'm about to put the slam dunk onto him. So let me go ahead and answer the question. Mm-hmm. The issue with the Quran actually made it clear, in alcohol there is some good, however, the bad is the good. So this is what the Quran said,
just get lost, stupid idiot. It's a waste of time to talk to you. It says in the front of you, it's a good, you made good from it, you made good nourishment of it. Indeed, you made good nourishment of it. Indeed, if you have sense, indeed you are a donkey. You are a certified donkey. Obviously, you do not know your book. It's a waste of time for someone like me. I can put my toes in a chat room and you cannot answer my toes. Who are you? So when you say, I'm going to debate the Christian prince, I want to debate the Christian prince, you're a potato. The Quran says there's some benefit. What some benefit? It says, I asked you, is it bad or good? And I repeated the question 100 times, so you can think about it carefully. And then finally, I made you say it. It's bad. It's bad. Chapter 16, verse number 67, Allah praises alcohol, claiming that He is the one who made it for us. It's for our benefit. So don't go around. You see, I just now give you like a bite. You know that, you know, you want to bite my shoe? I give you my shoe. But as you see, even my shoe, you cannot even bite it, because your mouth is so small. Potato. And if you want to talk about health and birth defect, I never saw birth defect as much in Islamic countries, because you marry from your cousin. And the proof of birth defect is you. Look at you. I mean, if you are not the proof of birth defect, who is the proof? Idiot. Shall I call him back again or give him one more chance? He will make a revolt.
Why did you run away?
I'm laughing.
What happened?
We are laughing. What happened? We have to take commercial break, because you are a birth defect yourself. So now, are you going to answer or not? Don't make an excuse. Are you going to answer how Allah, He says that alcohol is a great product, and it is a sign from Allah? And then you said to me from the beginning that it is from Satan. Is it the other verse? It says from Satan. Chapter 5, isn't it that verse? It says that alcohol is from Shaitan.
Okay, well, I want to make it clear, you hung up on me, you interrupted me, and this is a clear sign of power.
Everybody is laughing. Listen, this is recorded. Everybody laugh at you. So the verse in chapter 5, verse number 90, it says that alcohol is from Shaitan, correct? It is a handwork of Shaitan, correct?
Really? It is a handiwork of the devil, which is found in your book, right?
Nope. Okay, so now how the other verse is saying that it is the work of Allah?
It is what?
The work of Allah. What? It is the sign from Allah. It's a work of Allah. So chapter 16, verse number 67, it says, it is healthy, it is good, it's a fruit, it's amazing, it's beautiful, it's a good, it's nourishment, and it is a sign from Allah if you have any sense. So how it is a sign from Allah, and then the other chapter you gave me, it says it is the work or the handwork of Shaitan. Which one we should take?
Absolutely. And so this, as you can see, Christian Prince is running away from the real question tonight on how is it the Quran could give a better response. Now, what he's showing, okay, but I can show internal contradiction.
Don't change topic. Don't make me hang up on you, because you're a kid. You're just a kid, literally. I'm asking you. The question is very clear. Everybody is laughing at you. You are stupid like your prophet who said that the penis of the man will be endless. And I assure you are dreaming about that because you have a problem. Now listen, is it from God, this alcohol, or it's from Shaitan?
Okay, so as you can see, he's interrupting me. He's hanging up on me. And this is a sign of this from Christian.
Because I'm done with you. You're done. You're lost. I have nothing to say. I'm just giving you extra time. Just for, you see, listen. Brother Ahmed, you are here for one purpose, entertainment. You are just a joke. You are not a debater. You know nothing. What? So I'm asking you, the verse in chapter 16, verse number 67, don't make me repeat myself 1,000,000 times. It says that alcohol is made by Allah. It's a sign from Allah. It's a miracle of Allah. It's a great, it's amazing. And the other verse, the one you gave me, chapter 5, verse number 90, it says it's the handwork of Shaitan. So which one of them is accurate?
Okay, so one of the cowardice of Christian Prince, anybody can win a debate by interrupting their opponent, hanging up on them, and shoving questions.
You can interrupt me as much as you want. Still, you can't answer. What is the answer? People don't care for you. You can cry as much as you want. People are laughing. Which one is made by? Made by Allah or made by the devil? Is it bad or good? I'm waiting for the answer.
I told you this guy is scared to debate me. The Quran makes it very clear.
For sure. We are scared of you, my friend. So for sure. I mean, there's no two people that want to debate about it. You know, my friend, everybody's scared of you. You are a crazy person, brother. So now, is Shaitan is the one who made alcohol or Allah? Chapter 16, verse number 67 says it's made by Allah. Chapter 5, right. Verse number 90, it says made by Satan, and it's bad. So which one of them is accurate?
Okay, so the Quran does not state in Surah 16, verse 67, that the alcohol was made by Allah. You have lied. Now, do not interrupt me again. I did answer this question, as you can
see.
I think
verse.
He's running away.
Read the verse for us. Read the verse for us. Read the verse for Allah. Read the verse. You said it doesn't say that. Read the verse.
I want it to be clear to everybody. He's running away. He cannot debate me.
Read the verse. Let us see who's running away. I mean, we are having a debate. Oh, I'm asking you. Give me the answer. Read the verse. Okay, you are saying something is not there. It's in front of us. Does it say that it's a goodly provision? Okay, let me read for you. This is the Muslim translation. Okay, and a goodly provision. Do you see the word goodly provision?
Yes, it does not say. Okay, hold on.
Doesn't say what?
Clear. Christian Prince is a coward. Is it clear? He cannot have a fair debate with equal time. He's refusing to do so.
What equal time? I will give you more time than me. I will stay mute if you're answering. I'm asking you. Does it say there? You said to me, I asked you, is it a bad? You said, yes, it is bad. Women, they get babies and they have defect. Bad, for sure it's bad. Okay, the Quran here says, and it's a goodly provision. Verily, there is indeed a sign for people who have wisdom. So according to the chapter 16, verse number 67, the one who have wisdom is the one who drink alcohol.
Okay. So can I talk, or is this just your time to
stop crying? I'm trying to explain to you the question so you might answer. You are just trying to buy time. You do not know what to say. Go ahead.
Yeah, you did lie to people in which you said that you said alcohol is from Allah. We have you on tape. You're changing your statement. Oh, it's just a goodly provision. It means that there's some good in it. So now you just kind of change your original statement. So yeah, you did get busted lying
here
tonight.
Can I talk? Okay, you just said. Okay, hold on, guys. I said this is from Allah. It says that in front of you donkey. It says it's a sign. It's a sign. It's a miracle or ayat and ayat. You know what I mean? It's a miracle of Allah. Do you see the word sign? Are you a certified donkey like your prophet or you are not? You are. So it says here in the front of you, it's a sign for those who have a wisdom. The signs come from who? From God. Do you Muslim believe that signs come from Shaitan?
Are you going to let me talk without interrupting me?
So stop. Why you are saying we got me busted and this is not from Allah? If the verse in the front of you is saying, this is a sign from Allah. So beer is from Allah. It's a sign. Black label. We have another with us. And by the way, the Muslim, they used to drink and they pray. And even the Quran made a verse about it, praising it. And then because the Arab, they start laughing at Muhammad, he said to them, oh Muslims, Allah told me, don't pray when you are drunk. Chapter 4, verse number 43. Oh, who you believe, don't go to the prayer when you are intoxicated because you are drunk. So Zakir Naik, Nader Ahmad, all the potatoes in the world, they used to go to the mosque with the Prophet and they fill a pot around him. And the Arab, they start making in front of Muhammad and his followers. What kind of followers they are? Why Allah did not say from the beginning? And in the top of that, Allah, he praised alcohol and he claimed that alcohol is a sign from him. Why he did that? Because the Arab, they love to drink. You're my...
Well, there's no point of giving me the mic if you're going to interrupt me every 10 seconds. I mean, this is an act of cowardice on your part.
I'm just answering you. You made a statement. You said you got me busted. Yeah. You said you got me busted. The verse doesn't say it's from Allah, so I have to answer. It says in the front of it's a sign from Allah. So do you agree it's a sign from Allah or not?
I have never won a shouting match in my life. There's a different.
Listen. I want to answer. You see, shouting match. This is not shouting match. This is spanking match. You are being spanked. I want you to tell me.
Coward.
Does it say? Does it say in the verse a sign from Allah or not?
It's pointless. You're just going to interrupt me. What's the point about talking about
excuses? Here we go. It took me 5 minutes repeating my question to make you say that alcohol is bad, repeating my question 1 million times, and now you are going to do it again. So is it saying there that alcohol is a sign from Allah, or I'm lying?
Okay, so let it be clear. I'm going to answer your question, even though you're jerking me around, you're interrupting me.
Are you going to answer, is it a sign from Allah or not? You see, I am not anyone you can play with. You are talking to Christian Prince. I hold you from your tail, okay. I put you in the corner, and it doesn't matter how big the rat is in front of me, still you have no cheese. I'm going to repeat my question. Is it a sign from Allah, as the verse saying, or I'm lying?
No, it does not say it's a sign from Allah. It says it is a sign.
Then read the verse. Okay. Then read the verse. Read the verse. It says the word sign there. The sign is
there's a difference. Can I respond? Why are you so afraid to debate me, Christian Prince? Please keep in mind when you interrupt people. You want, that's not a debate, and that's
very in front of everybody, which interpretation you like to put in the screen,
Christian Prince.
Stop it, let everybody laugh at you. You want a Jalalain, you want a Tabari, you want Ibn Kathir, what do you want? I will put them for you, and okay. You will get you busted. You're a potato, so I'm asking you for the last time. I'm losing my patience. You're just a kid. Is it a sign from Allah or a sign from Shaitan? Here it says it's a sign for those who have wisdom. For who?
Yes.
For the one who have wisdom. So the Quran saying it clearly that those who have wisdom, they believe in the sign, which is dream drunk.
Can I respond? I mean, can I talk? I don't know. You just interrupt me for 4 seconds.
Nobody, you are the best joker ever. I love you, man. I love you. You know, God created a lot of funny things. I love you for the sake of God, because you are the best joker. Are you going to answer or not? You see, how many times I need to repeat my answer? When the Quran is saying it's a sign by whom? Who is the one who is giving the sign?
Can I talk? Are you letting me talk, Christian Prince?
No, you're not allowed to talk. I'm repeating the question, you donkey. Is it a sign from Allah? The word sign is coming from who? Who is the one who did the sign? Who is the one who did that sign? Go ahead.
Okay, so now please don't interrupt me. The text of the Quran, it is a sign. As that, the text did not say it's a sign from Allah.
So
the text did not say this.
Okay, it's from who?
What?
Guys, it's not from Allah. Okay, no. Finally, we got an answer. It doesn't say it's from Allah. It's from who?
Okay, Christian Prince, you are scared to debate me. It's very clear.
Coward, don't run, coward. I'm asking you. You said it doesn't say it's a sign from Allah. So are you saying that your God, he gave a sign from Shaitan, and he called it wisdom?
The text said, okay, listen, I don't want you to interrupt me again, Christian, because it's an act of cowardice. You're scared to debate me.
You are not answering. So is it a sign from Allah or a sign from Shaitan?
The text doesn't say, but now I'm done with you.
No, you are not done. We just started, you donkey. Where are you going? What do you mean you're done with me?
Okay.
Listen, is it a sign from Allah or a sign from Shaitan? Prove it to me. Whatever you say, you have to prove it to me. What interpretation you like us to show to everybody in listening? Because either you are lying, and this is a sign from Allah, or I am lying, and it's not a sign from Allah. So when we say it's a sign, is it a sign from Allah? You said it doesn't say that, and you said it doesn't, which means it's not. So can you get me busted, Your Majesty, Nader Ahmed, the scholar who have no, you don't have high school. Can you get me busted and show me the interpretation for the verse? Where it says this is not a sign from Allah. Where it says this Christian, is not a sign from Allah.
Christian Prince, I have to go. I cannot believe you jerking me around.
You have to go. Our mommy is coming. What, you want to change your diaper?
What?
Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go? What happened? No, you are in the corner. You are a potato, and you are a coward. You said this. You just admitted that Allah is Shaitan, because the Quran is saying this is a sign for those who have wisdom, and you deny that those who follow the wisdom, they are following the sign of God. You just deny that this is a sign from God by saying it doesn't say that. So you are a liar, and you are a potato. This is the topic you choose. and you don't want to answer because it's very embarrassing. Let us see how many Muslims will laugh at you about and you're the one who says, who will debate you? Who are you? Who are you? You don't know nothing. Here we go. I repeat again, don't tell me I have to go. Mommy, she will be upset. She will watch this video and she will be upset from you. Be a man, be the hero. So is it a sign from Allah or it is not?
I have to go. I want you to come into a public debate with me on the topic.
This is the kid, Nadir Ahmed, who go around and says he want to debate a Christian prince. This is why they don't dare to debate me. This guy, last time I spoke to him, it was maybe 12 years ago. And he admit he's a prophet, have sex with the goat. That's why they want to talk about it. He said, so what? Christian Prince, he ran away from me, Christian Prince. I mean, come on, this guy, he cannot debate me. You know, my name is not Dudu. You know, Dudu and Dudu, like Dudu, the Dudi, the Bada Duda, the Duda. You're a bit potato, you are a donkey. And this is the topic he chose. This is his choice, imagine. If this is his choice, this guy was thinking about it like he's scratching his ass for the last century. If I talk to Christian Prince, I would talk about what I would choose this topic. It's very powerful. It's an amazing topic. He cannot refute me. No, what's wrong with you? You are a potato. I invite you to public debate. Are you going to do better in public debate? This is public debate. I mean, how public we have? We have 1,400 people watching. I invite you to public debate, okay? So, public debate where people will die laughing at you. People will fall in the chair. People will sue me for dying from heart attack. Stupid. See how they try? They claim that they can debate you. They change the topic in the speed of light. This is why you have to hold them tight. Don't let them go. Learn how to debate. We don't debate with Abdul. We don't. We corner them. There's no debate. There's no debate with liars. Debate, it have to happen between two people have honesty. Muslims, when they defend Islam, they don't defend by honesty. They ask him, he made a verse, brothers, sisters, when you go to the mosque, brother, don't pray and you are intoxicated because beer is haram. Actually, he did not say it's haram. He says, it's don't pray when you are drunk. Okay, how in the world they can pray then? Because in order not to be drunk, you have to give them time. The Muslim, they have to pray 5 times a day. What time is going to be when you are, they are drunk all the time? And Muhammad himself, he used to teach Muslims how to make alcohol. There's tons of reference about it. If Allah, he care for not to have a birth defect for children, then he should forbid you from having sex with your own daughter, as the Quran chapter 25, verse number 54 says. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ نَصَبًا وَصِهْرًا. We go to the interpretation, it says, it's not forbidden for you to have sex with your daughter and the mother of your daughter if she is a daughter from adultery. So the Quran forbid you from having sex with your daughter if she is daughter from marriage, but if she is not, it's okay. If the Quran care not to have birth defect, he should not allow you to marry your first cousin. It's the same blood. In Islam, your God, he promised you, we did not even go to the second topic, which is the same topic. If alcohol is bad, how come Allah, he promised you to be in heaven? If alcohol is the handwork of shaitan, then how Allah is going to import alcohol to his heaven?